How do you buy an FPV controller today? Especially when there's so many to choose from, and when you ask the community, everyone basically says their controller is the best. Over the last 3 years, I've owned and flown nearly every FPV controller that you can buy, and I want to share with you how I would buy an FPV controller today. Because the truth is, which one is best really comes down to which one is best for you. But here's where it becomes even more difficult to decide, because there have been 5 new FPV controllers released over the last 12 months, with each one challenging both the Radiomaster TX16S and the TBS Tango 2 as the best FPV controller to buy. With more controllers than ever to choose from, this has also meant that the differences in the basic features of the radio are getting even smaller, but the things that set them apart are actually becoming larger. So let's look at how to buy an FPV controller and work out which one is best for you. Plus at the end, I'll give you some of my recommendations if you still can't decide. Now, as I said, most FPV controllers pretty much have the same basic features. These are the operating system, radio protocol, and the sticks or gimbals. Let's start with the operating system. FPV controllers, they're like a computer. They need an operating system to work. And like most PCs that run Windows, most FPV controllers run an open sourced operating system called EdgeTX.
Welcome to EdgeTX.
Or they're using a variation of it, like FreedomTX or OpenTX. So buying an FPV controller which has one of these operating systems means that all the software features, as well as how to use it, will either be the same across all radios, or there'll just be minor differences that need to adapt to the different hardware of the radio. And then there's the radio protocol, which is how your controller communicates with your FPV drone. And when you're buying an FPV controller, you're going to come across 3 kinds of radio protocols. The first is open source radio protocols like ExpressLRS. You've also got multi protocols like the JP4N1 or the CC2500. And then you've got the closed sourced or proprietary protocols like Crossfire, Tracer or FreeSky. But when it comes to choosing which radio protocol is on your controller, there are 2 kinds. But only one determines your buying decision, and that's what the internal protocol is. Because with most FPV controllers, you can buy a module and plug it in the back of the radio, and that really means the only decision you need to make is, do you want your radio protocol to be inside your radio, or are you okay with having to get a separate module that plugs into the back of your controller? Now, I don't recommend buying any FPV controllers with an internal multi-protocol module. And look, some people are going to say, well, what if you want to fly helicopters, RC planes, or a drone that has some weird radio protocol? The answers I give to this are simple. Both ExpressLRS and Crossfire can be put on a helicopter or an RC plane. And those toy drones with weird protocols that you're not going to get them to work anyway. And you can just buy a multi-protocol module and plug it into the back of your radio if you ever needed it. So my recommendation is to go with an FPV controller that has the radio protocol that you fly the most built into it. The only other basic feature that's common across most FPV controllers is the sticks or gimbals. And you're going to find that for many controllers, the sticks or gimbals are all using the same technology, which is based upon having a magnet and a sensor to determine where the stick is. And that's instead of having 2 moving parts that contact each other and use friction. Controllers which use the magnets and sensors are called Hall sensor gimbals, while the other kind is known as potentiometer gimbals. Typically, Hall sensor gimbals are seen as superior because they have less wear and tear compared to the friction between the contacting parts in potentiometer gimbals. That, over a long time, reduces their effectiveness, which can see them become less accurate, especially with heavy and frequent use. Manufacturers today are now producing gimbals that are either part aluminium or full CNC aluminium, but they do come at a premium. Now we understand the common basic features shared by most FPV controllers, let's look at the things that really set them apart from each other. The biggest difference in most FPV controllers today is their form factor. And we've seen new radios like the Radiomaster Pocket and the Jumper T20 really differentiate themselves and challenge the traditional game controller or box style form factors. And there's also these mini and mid-sized box style controllers like the Radiomaster TX12, the TBS Mambo, and the almost identical Radiomaster Boxer. One thing I've noticed is across all the different form factors is you can basically split them into 2 main categories, and those categories are defined by their gimbal size. You have full or standard size gimbals, and then you have your mini or micro gimbals. The 2/3, mid-box, and traditional box style radios all have full or standard size gimbals, While your mini box, gamepad, and hybrid gamepad style controllers all have mini or micro gimbals. Now, what gimbal and radio size you have doesn't actually make you a better pilot, although it does have an impact as to how you set up your rates in Betaflight. Now, this isn't to say one is better than the other, rather that you need to go through the process based upon the size of your gimbals to find your perfect rates. But now we're split either between standard or mini gimbals, and how do you choose between the different form factors? So in the mini or micro gimbal size, you have your hybrid gamepad, and mini box style controllers. While on the standard gimbal size, you've got your 2/3 mid box and full size box controllers. Now we understand both and what makes FPV controllers similar to each other, as well as what makes them different. How do you know which one is right for you? Now, before I give you my recommendations on what FPV controller to buy, if you need any help or have any questions, you can join the Hangar, which is my members only online community. Members in the Hangar also get access to the rewards program, promotions, as well as giveaways, as well as my affiliate program. Not to mention there are courses, guides, workshops, and tutorials. Just head to darrenfpv.com. Okay, so which controller would I recommend? Well, I'll give you a couple based upon who you are and what you need. If you're buying your first FPV controller or on a tight budget, the Jumper T-Lite V2 Express LRS is what I would recommend. But the limited FPV stores that have it, you're probably going to need to go on AliExpress to buy one. Otherwise, the Radio Master Pocket is carried by most stores. Now, if you want to buy a gamepad style controller, there are two I would recommend. If you're all in on Crossfire, then the Tango 2 is really the only option. But otherwise, the Jumper T Pro V2 Express LRS edition is a solid choice. Now, if you wanted to go with a box style radio with standard or full size gimbals, most people would say the TX16S Mark II, but I actually wouldn't recommend it unless you fly RC planes or helis. Rather, I think you'd actually be better off buying the Jumper T20. However, like the T-Lite, you're probably gonna have to get it from AliExpress or Banggood. And if you wanted to buy locally, the Radio Master Boxer is carried by most stores, so that's the one I would go with. Now, if you do have any questions, I'll see you over in the hangar. I'm Darren Allett. Until next time, don't forget to send it.